Hey there, this is Rene for Network Lessons. In this video, I'll show you how to configure Telnet on your Cisco IOS router or switch. So, let's have a look. I got two routers here, R1 and R2. And I'm going to use R1 as the Telnet server, and then we'll use R2 as the Telnet client. So, let me show you how to do this. First of all, we can check how many VTY lines we have. And these are the virtual terminal lines, and these define how many connections that you can establish. Now I'm using Cisco Viral here, and you can see that this emulated router has up to 924 lines, which is a lot. And most routers only have a couple of lines, like 5 or 16, and that's it. So what we'll do is I'll configure the first 5 lines, 0 to 4. And then we'll say transport input telnet. So we only want to use telnet. Let's specify a password, which will be my_password. And then we'll say login, which tells the router to ask for the password. Okay, now if I go to R2, we can do something like this. Telnet to this IP address. It says open, which means that it was able to connect. Type in the password and you are able to connect. Okay, so this is the most simple method to configure Telnet. But there are a couple of other things we can try. So, for example, instead of using a single password, it might be an idea to use usernames and passwords. So what we'll do is I'll say no password, and then I say login local. And this word local refers to a local database with usernames and passwords. So let's say username admin, and this is the password. Now if I go to R2 and I telnet again, then you can see that it prompts for the username. And I'm able to log in. So using usernames instead of a single password is probably a better idea, especially if you have multiple users that have to log into your router. Okay, what else can we do? Telnet is not secure since everything is sent in clear text. So it's a better idea to use SSH. But if you have to use Telnet for whatever reason, then you might want to make it a little bit more secure by using an access list. So, for example, I can say that I only want to permit Telnet traffic from this IP address. And this is the IP address of R2. So we got the access list. And then with the access class command, I can apply it to the VTY. Lines. So let's give this a try. So we'll go to R2 again. You can see it says open, so I'm still able to connect. And when I go back to R1 and we do a show access list, then you can see these two matches. Now if I would change the IP address on R2, so let's change the IP address for a moment. Let's make it 200. And then when I try to telnet to R1, you can see that it's being refused because of our access list. Okay, so let's correct the IP address. Okay, so that's the telnet server. What else can we do? Well, let me explain a couple of things about the Telnet client. So if you use the Telnet client and you use the question mark, you can see that it has quite some options. And there's a couple of them that are useful. So for example, you can see all these different port numbers. And we can use the Telnet client to connect to different TCP ports. Now, let me show you why this can be useful. For example, we can connect to the HTTP port, number 80. So if I go to R1, and let's enable the HTTP server. Now I'm going to telnet to port 80. And you can see that it says open. So I'm able to establish a TCP connection to destination port 80. And this is a great little trick to test if certain ports are up and running. And this is a bit faster probably than starting a web browser on your computer to test this. You can even try some HTTP commands here. So if I would try a GET request like this, HTTP, you can see that this GET request is accepted by the HTTP server, but it says unauthorized, and then it closes the connection. But at least this proves that I'm able to connect to this port and that it's up and running. The other thing we can do is you can specify a source interface. So let me give you an example for this. So what I'll do is I'm going to create another interface here on R2. A loopback with this IP address. And then I'll create a static route on R1 towards R2. And just to make sure, you can see that we are able to ping it. Now what I can do is, when I use the telnet command, I can specify the source interface. So I can say source interface loopback 0. And you can see that this is now being refused because of the access list on R1. If I remove it, then I'm able to telnet. Now this can be useful sometimes to test an access list, for example. You can also use it to connect to different ports. So let's connect again to TCP port 80. And then the source will be the loopback. And you can see that I'm able to connect. So this can be useful if you want to test if port 80 is running and if you're allowed to connect from a different IP address. In this case, the loopback. So specifying different port numbers and using different source interfaces, these are two useful commands that you can use for the telnet client. Now that's pretty much it. That's all I wanted to show you about telnet. I hope this has been useful. Thanks for watching, and till next time.